Hey everyone, hope that you all had a great week this week. Next week, we have a once in a decade or more, maybe once in two decades, opportunity to make a real difference on our waterways. So I want to share some information with you about how you can participate, join the fight with our neighbors on the East Coast and the West Coast that for far too long have been used as a septic tank for the rest of the state of Florida. Now, before we get into all of that, I want to tell you a bit about a new bill that I helped introduce this week. As some of you may know, the Department of Veterans Affairs, which I do a tremendous amount of work with, it's where I get all of my health care from, has been performing painful and distressing research experiments on dogs for a number of years. Now, this is heartbreaking to me as a dog lover. I got a beautiful German Shepherd, had other dogs throughout the years. You know, it's man's best friend. It's our family's, tremendous companion. And despite all of our efforts in recent years to cut funding from these programs, a number of VA facilities have continued to conduct horrible tests, including everything from drilling into dogs' skulls to inducing heart attacks, collapsing their lungs, other things like that, all as a part of medical research. Now, as someone who has benefited from medical treatments for veterans with prosthetics, I've also seen the important role that dogs can play in helping our veterans recover from the physical and psychological tolls of war. And in my opinion, the VA has gone too far in conducting these harmful tests, sometimes even fatal tests. Experiments on man's best friend for far too long that have been taking place, they need to come to an end. I believe that there is a line, and for me personally, this is where I draw that line. So this week, I helped to introduce the Preventing Unkind and Painful Procedures Experiments on Respected Species Act. That's a very long name, but it's been otherwise known as the Puppers Act, as we call it. We will finally put an end to these terrible and abusive tests once and for all. It's very important to me, and I know it's very important to people that just love animals in general. It's very important to a number of our veterans. This is something that we know very well, the need for medical research that exists out there. We want to see advancements be made, but we also know that there is a line that we will not cross in order to get to that point, and this is that line. Now I want to move gears to the other issue that I started talking about in the beginning of this video, on our waterways. I want to share with you some very important information on how it is that you get involved in the fight to put an end to greatly reduce the discharges out of Lake Okeechobee into our coastal communities. Now, for the past few weeks, we've been talking a lot about the importance of attending the Army Corps of Engineers public forums, and today I want to walk through the other ways to make your voice heard. Now, first, if you're planning on attending a meeting, then you should be prepared for the opportunity to give a 2-minute long spoken argument, or up to about 2 minutes, to speak your argument, what you want the Corps of Engineers to know. Now, I always tell people, you know, we can go out there and we can tie the Corps of Engineers to the whipping post and yell at them about different things that we might be upset about, but that doesn't help get us to where it is that we really need to get to. The Corps of Engineers is coming in to hear our arguments, to hear the data and the science and the facts and the statistics and the very real effects that discharges have had on our community, or had on our health, or had on our businesses, or our recreation, or other important parts of our life. This is what they want to hear about, and I'm trying to give everybody the best information on how to best deliver that message so that it will be taken into consideration through this redo of the Lake Okeechobee Regulation Schedule, now known as LOSOM, the Lake Okeechobee System Operating Manual. So, I said, number one, you should prepare a 2-minute spoken testimony that you want to share with the Corps of Engineers about something that concerns you about these discharges of Lake Okeechobee and what you want to see change about the policy. You should also have those comments written down, typed out on paper somewhere, so that when you get done telling the Corps of Engineers what you think, you can hand that paper to the Corps of Engineers and tell them that you want to submit that to them for the record. Now, any questions that you put in there, that you put in writing for them for the record, the Corps of Engineers will have to get back to you on. I would encourage you to have your address, your email address, things like that, all as a part of that information, your name, so that the Corps of Engineers can get back to you with that information. The next two meetings that you will have the opportunity to attend and do this, Tuesday, February 19th in Stuart at Indian River State College. The first meeting will be from 1 to 3 p.m. and the second meeting from 6 to 8 p.m. Now also, on that paper where you have your written comments out, I said, put questions on there that you have. There's no questions that you should take for granted in asking the Corps of Engineers. It's important to have them on record about how they really feel about different things. One of the examples that I give people about a very simple and straightforward question, but something that the Corps should be on record about is, Corps of Engineers, can you tell us what amount of discharge out of Lake Okeechobee, freshwater discharge out of Lake Okeechobee, is healthy for our coastal East Coast estuaries? What amount of that discharge benefits us? What amount of that discharge hurts us? Now, a lot of us that live on the coast can say there's none of it that benefits us, but that's important to have the Corps on record for. That's why I say ask the questions, put them in writing, let the Corps know that you're gonna hand it to them, that you're gonna email it to them, that you're gonna mail it to them, and that you want answers to your question. Now, if you can't make it to a meeting, but you want to participate, you can submit your public comments also online. I encourage you, submit them at www.mast.house.gov/lores, as well as emailing it to lakeocomments@usace.army.mil. So finally, the last thing that I want to tell you is this. You can also send any written comments through the mail to Dr. Ann Hodgson at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Jacksonville District, P.O. Box 5970, Jacksonville, Florida, 32232. This is where you can go send all of their comments. I want to make clear that each one of these ways to participate are equally important in our fight to ensure our community's voice is heard, to make sure that what occurred, in my opinion, in Lores 2008, where there's this idea of shared adversity that goes on, but the fact that we have had to share in all of the adversity and we don't share in any of the prosperity, that is the problem with the current Lake Okeechobee regulation schedule. We have to take all of these discharges on the East Coast along with people to the West Coast, which do not benefit our East Coast at all, but we don't get any benefit of that. Everybody else shares in the benefit of that. We have to take the brunt of the adversity. That relationship simply cannot continue. Our health on the coast, our human safety on the coast, our environment on the coast, our economy on the coast has to be taken into consideration. We cannot allow these discharges to simply come into our community without us being taken into consideration. Together, we have a once-in-a-lifetime, a once-in-a-multi-decade, certainly, opportunity to prevent discharges and put an end to the lost summers that we've experienced once and for all. Now, it's absolutely critical that we keep the pressure on the Army Corps, ask them the tough questions, ask them respectfully, ask them to answer us respectfully, but we want to make sure that this is the way that it takes place so that we can all benefit from a better Lake Okeechobee operating system. We may not get another chance at this for probably another 20 years. That's how important it is. So here are some of the questions that you can start with, even when we know the answers. As I pointed out already, it feels silly asking it sometimes for us, but it's important to force them to answer the questions that we want them to take into consideration. What amount of discharge out of Lake Okeechobee is good for the ecology of the Caloosahatchee? What amount of discharge out of Lake Okeechobee, those freshwater discharges, benefits the St. Lucie River? Is cyanobacteria a toxin? Does the Corps of Engineers consider cyanobacteria to be a toxin? We need to have them on record to answer things like this. Will the science of how the discharges out of Lake Okeechobee impact the estuaries to the east and the west coast be taken into consideration? What level of toxicity exceeds what the Army Corps of Engineers would consider acceptable to discharge to populations on the east and the west coast when we're talking about cyanobacteria and microcyst and other bacteria that can be in the water? Does the Indian River Lagoon contribute any nutrients or any pollutants back into Lake Okeechobee? Or is it only Lake Okeechobee that takes its nutrients and dumps them into our east coast estuary? Is human health and human safety of people living on the east and the west coast as important as the health and the safety of those that are south of Lake Okeechobee who are threatened by the potential of Herbert Hoover Dyke failing. Is our health and safety just as important as those health and safety questions? These are questions that the Corps needs to answer along with all of the questions that you have. This is now our chance to get them to answer those questions in writing for the record and have it taken into consideration in this process. Remember, the Army Corps must respond to all public comments that are submitted. Now, if you have any questions on how to participate, feel free to contact my office and we would be happy to help you on any front that you have questions on. On that note, I hope that you all have a great week ahead. I hope to see many of you at these meetings in Stuart as we're moving forward, and the other ones in Broward and Palm Beach and other places. And as always, I just want to let you know, it is an honor to serve you in Congress here as your representative. I wish you all the best and we'll see y'all around.